All right, welcome back, and you're still watching New Day. You know that in the world of fashion, perception is indeed reality, and that the way you appear will determine how people address you or people form opinions about you based on the way you appear. For this segment on the show, we'll talk more about appearance, about personality style, we'll talk about fashion and how you can also appear fashionable in order to attract the right kind of clients or customers to whatever it is that you are doing. Now, to help us do this discussion, I've been joined by Ernest Cranton, who's a celebrity stylist and then the CEO of DeBerry's Outlook. Ernesto, you're welcome. Good, good, good. All right. So let's start a conversation. You know, typically, people relegate issues of fashion to the background when it comes to their lifestyle because most people think that, well, I'm not a celebrity. I'm not on TV. I don't sing. I don't dance. I'm not a footballer. So I'm not concerned about fashion. But from your expert point of view, should everybody be concerned about fashion?
Yeah, I think fashion goes for all. And it does not have a particular person or individual who is supposed to always be fashionable. Fashion goes for all. It can be, it properly comes in when it comes to issues of occasions, like such of weddings, gatherings, and then parties and stuff. Some people love to go fly and also wear in new costumes that they can use to exhibit or showcase what they've got. So I think fashion goes for everybody.
But
basically, generally, we think that fashion is for only the celebrities and the stars, but actually it's for everybody.
It's for everybody.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know how best I can put this, but I think even my teacher can also be fashionate when coming to class.
Teacher in the classroom, the chalk on the board can also appear fashionable.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah, sure.
That's an interesting point you raise. You see, and then the other thing too is that a lot of men, for example, don't really care about fashion. They're like, well, I'm just a man. I'll get up, get my tie and suit, and then I move out of the house. But from the kind of work you do, is that the case for men to also be particular about their fashion? Because it appears that the perception is that there's only women who talk about fashion and their handbag and their everything too much and all that. How should men approach the subject of fashion?
Okay. You know, when fashion comes into your head, we mostly think about the women. But I think fashion is a universal thing and a unisex thing. It's both for men and then women. And then when it comes to men concerning fashion, I think recent days we see most of our celebrities who are males across borders and also in Ghana dressing well and then coming in and out with the best costumes. And I think fashion matters most when it comes to men also. So I think fashion is for all. It's not just for men, it's not just for women, but it's for all. Yeah.
Okay. Let's stay a bit on men. So for example, a man decides to go for an occasion like a party, a birthday party.
Yeah.
How would you expect a man, for example, to dress for such an occasion?
Nice question. A party. It depends on the kind of party. It could be a boys party that the man should be dressed in a street wear. And also when it comes to formal parties, it already tips into the head. You should also be dressed formally. And when it comes to official parties also, you know what to put on. So mostly fashion and costumes also comes in depending on the kind of occasion that is going on. Yeah, so I think mostly we need to look at the kind of occasion that is going on before we put on any costume that we put on. You know, some people think every costume, you know, when I wear this, I think I'm okay. At least I'm showcasing what I've got. But, you know, sometimes we get it wrong. Ghanaians, sorry, I can't put it as Ghanaians, but like actually Africans, per se, we copy the Europeans. Mm-hmm. We watch their videos and stuff, and we think that what they put on during videos are the best thing we could put on. You could walk on streets, hot sunny day, you find a man putting on a jacket, a pullover, you know, it's kind of weird. But you know, when really you go into details and you really want to do fashion, you put on what suits the best occasion. So I think for instance, when we talk about fashion, I think we're doing well and we're giving out the best comparing to that of women, because women also, I would say, they're doing well when it comes to fashion though, but sometimes they normally don't know what exactly to put on because they don't have a perfect stylist to show them what they should put on. But they think maybe, oh,
anything goes.
At least if I put on this.
We'll come to that point where we'll talk about the stylist, more of the stylist. But let me also put this to you. You know, people complain that we don't have so much money to appear fashionable,
yeah.
You know, because the perception is that for the celebrities we see on TV, Hollywood, Ghana, and all over the place, they have huge bank accounts that can actually cater for the stylish kinds of clothing and other things that they wear. But for the ordinary person who's concerned about fashion but may not have that much money, for example, to even get the services of a personal stylist,
yeah,
and get the money to buy all the so-called designer things and all that, how would you advise such a person to, okay, you know, within the means still appear fashionable and very attractive?
Okay, a stylist comes in based on a purpose, like, or like a stylist can come in when actually he is needed, because a mere person by the roadside can't just call in for a stylist to style me because I'm going for a wedding or something. But mostly stylists do style celebrities because they can afford. Mm-hmm. But actually we have individuals also who can afford the cost. Yeah, and then they call in stylists as someone like me who I'm also a professional stylist. I'm doing good out there and I think I'm giving out my best. So normally I get calls not from only the celebrities, but I get calls also from people around, people who wants to have their weddings, gatherings and stuff. So I think
stylist, it shouldn't let it happen. Okay.
It should be open.
So because of our time, excuse me, I'm rushing it, but let me put this final question to you. You are a stylist by profession.
Yeah.
Is this something you encourage other people to go into? Is it lucrative? Is this something that people can take that as a full-time career and then they'll be okay?
Okay, it goes for those who think they want to do this, because I can't just force you to do something. But if you think fashion and also being a stylist is what you've always wanted to do, I think I can encourage you, because per se, let's talk like somebody like me, like this, for way back I also wanted to be in the stylist stuff, but I thought it costs so much, it demands a lot, so I was concentrating basically on something else. But I had a friend who inspired me a lot, and who is also into this.
So you encourage other young people to
Yeah, I encourage. Okay. Yeah.
All right. Ernest Cranton is a celebrity stylist and the CEO of The Berry's Outlook.